I guess I want to ask, and this is for anybody who's watching, and I try to pose my questions as though I'm a person who really wants to get into your industry. First and foremost, did you see this? Like, you are an extremely important person. You're very successful. There are not too many people that are not in your contact base where you just can't pick up the phone directly and reach them. When you were coming up, even before you got your first internship, did you see this day for Datwon Thomas?
Wow, man. I was speaking on this the other day, man. I said that, like, I was dreaming about being within the industry and being with all these different movers and shakers, but I never really saw it to the degree that it reached and continues to reach. Just being able to speak to a Diddy or speak to a Jay or speak to someone in those kind of caliber levels, a Damon John or Shark Tank, like, to be able to exchange ideas at any point. Andre Harrell, who helped me, you know, tremendously in my career. I think about those kind of levels and those moments, and I'm like, wow, man. Like, I was just that kid in Brooklyn looking at them on my wall, you know what I mean? And going to their events and just trying to, you know, studying through different magazines and stuff like that, just trying to get the insight to where if the opportunity arose, I would be ready to be able to have conversations with them, let alone work with them on different projects. Did I see it? I saw some form of it, but I never saw it this robust.
Wow. You know, you just mentioned Andre Harrell, and I referred to you early in the conversation as a hip-hop culturalist. Mm-hmm. Andre did so much for this culture.
Yes, indeed.
Hip-hop, R&B. Can you tell me from your standpoint, mm-hmm, what Andre meant to the culture and what he meant to you personally?
Wow, man. What Andre meant to the culture, he was the blueprint on how to take hip-hop and expand it to its current height. What we're experiencing now, he expanded that. You know, he worked with Russell Simmons. Russell's the bro. He helped him with Def Jam. Def Jam was about the essence of hip-hop, the street, the core principles of hip-hop, and being able to expose that. What Andre did was like, yo, I'm going to take it. I'm going to add the fashion element. I'm going to add the high-level executive element. I'm going to add the street element on some flyness. And then I'm going to take that to the next level and infuse that in the TV and film. You know, New York Undercover and things of that nature. The videos are going to have a step above. We're going to have like a classy thing where, you know, those midday brunches and stuff like that. Like, he brought that, like, that certain level of elegance mixed with street, but he wanted it to still be black. He wanted it to still have our flavor to it. So that's what he did culturally. And he did it on an extraordinary music level, man, just to be able to not only be a iconic music executive in his own right, but to bring along even more iconic, you know, executives behind him, as well as take the transition of an artist, say Heavy D, and make him an executive. You take a dope MC, make him a superstar artist, and then you also usher him into the executive ranks. That's just beautiful. Now, that's just one person. You know what I mean? Right. And then on the personal side, when I got into the industry, he was one of those guys that I always looked up to, I always respected. And when I was introduced to him, you know, he automatically was on some, like, you know, he checked you out. He's like, all right, let me see if this kid got flavor. What's up with him? Then he would try to, he'll ask you a question and try to see where were you within the cool zone? What was your demo? Were you the dirty backpack kid? Were you the, like, super cool club kid? What kind of dude were you? And I think at that point in my career, I was, like, really breaking a lot of artists in XXL. And he saw where I was going with it. And he helped me so much when I started King. It was just like an amazing friendship and being an executive and ushering me in.
Nah, he really was an amazing person, an amazing spirit. And I think he's done so much for this culture. And I'm so happy to see that people recognize his contribution. I, you know, obviously was a good friend of his, have known him for many years. So I totally understand what he meant to the culture, but to really see how people have given it up to him and you know, shared their personal experiences just like you just did. I was so happy for him. So he would be dearly missed by so many, and his impact, maybe, not just on hip-hop culture, but on the world. That whole Black excellence, ghetto fabulous, uptown.
Oh, yeah.
He really cemented that in the world. So he definitely did his thing. I remember, you know, Andre, he did an interview. And he was on one of these mainstream, I don't know if it was CNN or it was one of these mainstream outlets. And he was talking and he brought his whole ghetto fabulous vernacular to it. He was right. Like, you know, we out there and we chilling in the Hampty Hamps. I'm like, no, go ahead, Dre. So that's just the kind of person he was.
The Hampty Hamps.
There you go.
Oh, man.
But, you know, for you, I want to take a step back in your story. I know that you... What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.